We've made a video about pi, the ratio of a circle's circumference to its diameter. But there's a less famous, but equally fundamental number known to anyone who's taken high school algebra. It's about 2.71828182845905, and so on. And it was first defined by Jacob Bernoulli, but later Leonard Euler called it E, and the name stuck. Bernoulli first defined E through compound interest. Now, compound interest says that you get a little bit of money in interest every period, and that money you gained helps you gain even more interest next period. In other words, your interest compounds. So, if you stick $1 into a bank account with 100% interest rate compounded annually, you'll get $2 at the end of a year. If it's compounded semi-annually, you'll end up with $2.25. Quarterly, and you'll end up with $2.44. Monthly, $2.61. Weekly, $2.69. See where we're going? If you increase the number of compounding periods a year towards infinity, then you'll get closer and closer to E dollars. In statistics, it describes the most important statistical distribution, the normal. In biology, it models populations of species through the logistic function. In physics, E describes the exponential decay of a radioactive material. So, while E may not be as famous as pi, it's easily as fundamental and immensely important.
The number pi is equal to 3.14159265 and so on and so on. And it represents the ratio of any circle's circumference to its diameter.
We explain how Archimedes chose pi from parametros, meaning perimeter, when determining the circumference of a circle. But what Archimedes used pi to represent wasn't the constant 3.14159 we know it as today.